All right, let's wrap it up. So, what's important here? Change yourself. Check yourself. Be better. Be more open-minded. Be willing to stop and consider things. Do the hard thing. Really study your opponent's position. Stop yourself when you're finding an emotional reaction. You know, breathe, count to 10, whatever you have to, but get back into the thinking space. Take the emotion out of it. Don't jump to the conclusion of this is going to mean this if it's true. No, just what am I looking at right in front of me? So try to change yourself, and we can work better together if we will stop grouping. I mean, you have to do it yourself. Can't change what other people are doing, but you can change what you're doing. Try not to group people and throw people out and stop listening to them, which is very difficult. I block people on social media quite often. I don't want to hear this. And of course, certain things are just so hateful. I go, you know what? I don't really care to know you. But some things are just, well, they disagree with me. I don't want to hear any more from them. That's not going to help you grow. And sometimes it may reinforce that you're right, but at least you looked at the day. You looked at the other person's view and were, oh, okay, I can see why that's not right. But when you just throw them out because they disagree with you. So try not to do that. And if you want to persuade others, like I said, people are complex. Talk about other things besides the thing you disagree on and find that common ground and build on the things that you have in common that you agree on. This is really just to get yourself out of the I'm not going to listen to you group in their head, to get them out of that emotional space or maybe get them into a positive emotional space. But you coming head on against their beliefs ain't going to work. So get in there, listen to them, take advantage of every opportunity you can to agree and go, well, that's right, or I agree with that, or you know, that's really supported. Get in their herd. I'm going to give one example, and then I'll wrap it up here. But I used to be part of a organized skeptical society, believe it or not, out here, and I was going to this group called the Inner Peace Movement that was selling crystals and doing all kinds of stuff. And I went to their little seminar, and they talked about, okay, rub your hands together real fast for a while, and now you can feel the aura. You know, your hands just tingle anyway when you do that, but you know, you feel the aura. Go up to people, and you can feel their aura. And we were doing that, and I've been just playing along. I didn't say what I was there for. I was just, you know, paid my money, went with everybody else. And then I started getting along the wall and going, oh, I can feel the wall has an aura too. And people started kind of laughing. And I kind of took that approach, and people got on board with me, started going, yeah, this is a crock. And the whole crowd started kind of laughing and feeling like they were in on the joke, and they were part of it, and they were smart because they had figured it out. I didn't just come up and say, y'all are idiots. You know, they'd figured it out, and suddenly it was the herd kind of shifted, and it was cool to start laughing at what was going on here and not taking it seriously, whereas before it was very not cool. And that was kind of an accident. I'm not that clever. But the reason I bring it up as an observation is another one of our team members went to another session of this thing. And when the speaker started talking about their credentials, she goes, excuse me, where did you get your doctorate? What is yours a doctorate of? Where are your credentials exactly? Started attacking right off the bat. And the crowd, you know, well, I paid to be here. So if the speaker's an idiot, then that makes me an idiot. Well, they weren't in on the joke. They were seeing her as being hostile to all of them, and she was cooked. She had no chance of making any points with anyone because they had lumped her. She could have done the same thing I did, and they would have said you're wrong because they weren't part of that. You know, that connection wasn't there, and she was thrown out in their heads as invalid. It's not scientific. Doesn't make sense to do that, but admit it. We do it. You do it. Try to work on from the us standpoint, and it's very slow and very hard, but once you get into that place where they respect you and trust you in certain areas, hey, and it goes the other way, you respect them and trust them in certain areas, then you can learn from each other and maybe improve your models to be more accurate and actually reflect the real world more than just your little herd and what you instinctively want to think. Love each other, be kind, be open-minded, and try to avoid being a lizard, okay?